Good evening, everyone. Those stories shortly, but first, we're talking about the thick smog that has now developed in parts of South Asia, covering every street corner. Well, especially India's capital, New Delhi, was really tough outside, even coming in a little bit last night with hazy weather. Look at that. You can't even see the roads, right? Well, the air quality in New Delhi, very poor. Now, that's prompted the Indian Medical Association to, in fact, declare a public health emergency. The Delhi government has also pressed the panic button and will take a decision by this evening on whether or not to shut down schools until the situation gets better. Well, meanwhile, the environmental body, EPCA, has also recommended to increase the parking fees by 4 times. That's right, going up by 4 times, quadrupling the parking fee rate in New Delhi and the NCR, the National Capital Region. In fact, it's even called on the Delhi government to bring back the odd and even scheme. Here's a report filed by our correspondent, Nagin Singh, in New Delhi. All right, we'll get to that in just a bit. Let's also listen into a reaction now coming in.
See, it's an alarming state. Once it crosses 400, it comes into the severe zone. 300 to 400, we call it as a very poor zone. And definitely measures are being taken. There is a sudden change in the weather yesterday, where the wind speed has gone down to 1 to 2 meters per second. Wind direction, which was not coming to the Punjab side to this side, it has also drifted to this side. And that's why the biomass burning in Punjab is making its effect over here also. The humidity level has gone up to from 80 to 90%. And we expect that from 5 p.m. onwards, this humidity level up till 11 a.m. it will go up further. So we are taking all such measures that NTPC, Badarpur power plant, we have closed it down. And we have advised that water sprinkling should be done at the, especially the construction sites. The manual cleaning of the ground should be stopped. Rather, machinized cleaning should be done. Mm-hmm. That is important issues we are taking.
Well, several factors have contributed to the worsening situation. Fog, as well as coupled with the onset of winter and burning of stubble and neighboring regions in around the NCR. It's all given rise to a poisonous concoction of smog. In fact, visibility levels have declined sharply, leading to flight and train delays across the city. Well, the situation is in fact so grave that the National Green Tribunal, in fact, took the governments of Delhi, Uttar Pradesh and Haryana to task and asked them to explain why preventative steps were not taken to control the severe air quality in the region. All right, well, here are some of the ill effects of the smog. It is dangerous. You are best to stay indoors and avoid it. It can cause lung damage. It can also cause difficulty in breathing. Also, irritants to your throat and chest, of course, coughing as well. There's also threats of asthma attacks for those who have breathing problems. Could also be irritation in the eye, cold and pneumonia, as well as premature death even. Well, the Indian Medical Association has declared a public health emergency in Delhi. As we've talked about, the pollution, the smog, it has completely engulfed the city. I mean, if you go out in the streets, really will be surprising to see so much of smog. In fact, it makes driving conditions pretty tough out there, or even to see from one point to the next, as we're seeing in this video there. Look at that. You really can barely see the next person walking. Well, reports also say that the IMA president, Dr. Agarwal, has also said that people must avoid stepping out. So the big news, stay indoors, don't leave just yet. And if you're itching to, best to be inside to protect yourself. In fact, the declaration of health emergency came particularly late. This because the matter has now crossed to more than the 999 level. The PM was 2.5, which is above 900 level, while the PM was 1.0, that crossed 377. The reports say that the Indian Medical Association has also sought the cancellation of the Airtel Delhi Half Marathon, keeping in view that the rising pollution and deadly smog.
PM 10 is sakat mein 999 cross kar raha hai, aur PM 2.5 almost 900 cross kar raha hai, aur PM 1.0 kariban 377 cross kar raha hai. Ye public health emergency hai. IMA declares Delhi in a public health emergency state. School bandh ho jane chahiye, log gharon se bahar नहीं निकलने चाहिए, खासकर एल्डरली, प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज, बच्चे, हार्ट के पेशेंट, अस्थमा के पेशेंट, बाकी सब लोगों को भी प्रिकॉशंस लेनी चाहिए। एक्टिविटी बंद होनी चाहिए, पार्कों में जाना बंद होना चाहिए, फॉरगेट अबाउट जॉगिंग, इवन नॉर्मल वॉकिंग एज ऑन टुडे, आज के दिन में नहीं करना चाहिए।
Well, with such high pollution levels, people do need to take care of their health by taking some extra precautions, especially during the smog. So here are some things that you can do right now, especially when it is smoggy season and the pollution levels are pretty tough in the NCR and other parts of the country as well. All right, avoid high traffic areas, especially during rush hour. It can definitely cause irritations like breathing problems, if not now, perhaps later on, impacting your health. Also, try to avoid vigorous activities. So running, biking during smoggy environments, well, that is a huge no-no. Also, don't rub your eyes. You don't want that irritants to appear there. And people should make sure they are careful and with even itching. Also, those who have asthma or any kind of patients with breathing problems or any kind of allergies, definitely avoid walking outside, especially early in the morning when the levels could be a little bit more than at other parts of the day. All right, so those are some tips that you could perhaps use. In fact, there's also another one that we were reading about. In fact, if you have jaggery or honey, those are supposed to help your immune system. So who would have thought honey and jaggery to the rescue with all of this air pollution plaguing our cities? Well, let's take a look broader. Broaden this out, not just India, but how the rest of the world is doing or perhaps attempting to reduce the air pollution. Well, compared to India, China has taken some major and drastic steps in improving air quality, especially in the capital city of Beijing. It's always New Delhi and Beijing competing, right, for the worst air-polluted city. Well, the air quality has improved in Beijing. This after the government took strict and stern measures, including removing coal-fired power plants from the city and also putting a restriction on vehicles there. Well, how did China tackle this? What was their success? Is this something that India perhaps could learn? As we pointed out, it limited the number of vehicle registrations in the city. It also removed coal-fired plants. And get this, it also relocated some of those factories emitting higher pollution and reduced field burning. Things we see out on the farms like the agricultural stubble, all a big no-no. China said, stop that, we're not doing that, we're not allowing that. Situation is also very similar in Lahore, Pakistan. Well, just about 400 kilometers away from New Delhi, not too far, still in Asia, South Asia, a choking under a toxic sky with high pollution levels. In fact, we even spoke to our WION correspondent there, Taha Siddiqui, and not much of a different story to tell than NCR in Delhi, just like the Indian capital. Well, on the ground measures, well, they remain a distant dream in Pakistan's second largest city.